Hope you are fine and doing well. Today, the topic of discussion is study designs. A study design is a plan to conduct a study which allows the researcher to translate a conceptual hypothesis into an operational one. It is the method of data collection with respect to time, exposure, and outcome. The selection of a study design depends upon the research objective and hypothesis. The researcher should know and use the most appropriate study design that matches best with the objective. In short, study design is the process of planning an investigation, and it forms the bridge from idea to action. A study design can be explorative, descriptive, explanatory, or experimental. Study designs are broadly divided into two main types, descriptive and analytical. In descriptive studies, a researcher quantifies the distribution of certain variables in a study population at a point of time, while in analytical study, which may be observational or experimental, the researcher tests real stated hypotheses. Descriptive studies are used for generating hypotheses. These studies may be case report studies, case series, descriptive incidence studies, descriptive prevalence studies, which are also called as cross-sectional studies, and ecological or correlational studies. Analytical studies, which are of two types, observational or non-experimental, and experimental studies. In observational studies, the researcher mainly observes what is happening or what has happened in the past and tries to draw a conclusion based on these observations. While in experimental studies, the investigator assigns an intervention to one of the groups, and other distinguishing features of the experimental study is the process of randomization. Observational study designs are used for generating or testing the hypothesis, and case control studies, cohort study, and comparative cross-sectional studies are the example of observational studies. Experimental designs are used for testing the hypothesis, and randomized controlled clinical trials, which are also known as gold standard, and quasi-experimental designs are the examples of experimental study designs. Descriptive or observational designs are used for generating the hypothesis, while analytical studies are used for generating or testing the hypothesis. The difference between hypothesis testing and hypothesis generation is that in a hypothesis generation studies, only an association between an exposure and an outcome can be established. While on the basis of an hypothesis testing design, one can say with confidence that a certain exposure causes a certain outcome. The experimental studies are randomized control studies and interventions. These are the most robust of studies and the only hypothesis testing study, hence are considered the gold standard. The observational studies are weaker studies and can only generate a hypothesis. The basic variable that defines a study design is time. If both the exposure and outcome are determined at the same point, it is a cross-sectional study. If the outcome has occurred and researcher goes back from the outcome towards exposure, it is a case control study. And if patients are followed from the exposure towards the outcome, then it is a cohort study or experimental study. I will discuss all these studies one by one in upcoming sessions. Subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further updates. Stay blessed.